So here this is the condensation and the boiler diagram. So in the condensation, the hot fluid is parallel to the x-axis and the cold fluid is gradually increased from inlet to outlet. So in the, this is the condensation process. In the boiling concept, the boiling is along the x-axis. It is parallel to the along the x-axis and the hot fluid is gradually decreased from inlet temperature to outlet temperature. So here in this comparison, the condensation is in the condensation process is always parallel to the condensation process. The hot fluid is always parallel to the x-axis. In the boiling concept, the cold fluid is parallel to the x-axis. So these are the main difference. So here in the condensation, THi is equal to TH0. Okay, so in the boiling concept, in the T cold fluid inlet temperature is equal to T cold fluid outlet temperature. So this is the boiling concept and this is the condensation concepts. In the similar manner, so here delta T and delta T1 and delta 2 is constant like this. So here delta T1 is same difference, delta T is the same difference and delta T2 is the same difference. That means constant value we can draw like this. So now I am explaining parallel flow and counter flow problems in the LMTD method. So in a lubricating oil cooler, hot oil flowing at the rate of 2000 kg per hour, 2000 kg per hour is 2000 kg per hour is cooled from 100 degrees to 60 degrees. So here the lubricating oil cooler, hot oil flowing at a rate of, so hot oil rating at a rate of, that means mass flow rate, is cooled from 100 degrees to 60 degrees. So here the hot oil temperature, so hot oil inlet temperature is 100 and hot oil outlet temperature is 60 degrees. Using cold water at 10 degrees. So using cold water at 10 degrees, the flow at the rate of 1500, that means MC. So here the cold fluid mass flow rate and so here the hot fluid mass flow rate is 200 and cold fluid mass flow rate is 1500. The specific heat of the oil, so here oil means hot oil, specific heat means CPH value, 2.6 kilojoule per kg Kelvin, and water is CC, specific heat of the water is 4.2 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. Determine the rate of heat transfer and outlet temperature of the cold fluid. So here rate of heat transfer means Q, which is unknown value, we can find it, and outlet temperature of the cold fluid, that means TC0. So in this problem, TC0 value is not given, we need to calculate, and here the 10 degrees is TCI value. Okay, so in the hot fluid is oil and the cold fluid is water, the flow rate is 200 by 2000 kg per hour, we can convert it into hour like this, seconds. So that means 2000 by 3600 and cold fluid is 1500 by 3600 kg per second. Hot fluid temperature inlet temperature is 100, cold fluid inlet temperature is 60, and cold fluid inlet temperature 10 degrees, and TC0 is the we can find the TC0 value. So here CPH value, so in the kilojoule we can convert into 10 cube, CPH and CPC value is given. The heat transfer rate Q equal to, so Q equal to MHCH into THA minus TH0. This is the standard formula in the heat exchangers. Q equal to MHCH into THA minus TC0. So like this. So here THA minus TC0 like this. THA minus TC0. In the parallel flow and counter flow, the hot fluid temperature MHCH into delta T is equal to THA minus TC0. THA minus TC0. So we can substitute MHCH value, THA and TH0 values like this. So here Q value. So in this problem, what is the rate of heat transfer? Determine the rate of heat transfer. Now I can calculate a Q value like this. So this can be in the cold fluid of water, Q equal to mc cc into tc naught minus tca. So here this is the parallel flow heat exchanger, that's why I'm considering like this. So here what is the highest value? So in this both cases TC naught is the highest values in the parallel flow and counter flow. So TC naught is the highest value, that's why I'm considering TC naught minus TCA. TC naught minus TCA. So here Q equal to MHCH into TC naught minus TCA. So here TC naught is the unknown value. So we can find like this. This is the TC naught is unknown factor. So here Q is equal to already known value. And MCCC value is known and TCA is equal to 10 degrees. We can simplify like this, TC naught equal to 43.01. So in the gate examinations, so MH value is given, THA is given, TH naught is given, TMC is given, TCA is given, TC naught is not given. So in the heat transfer rate, the cold fluid is equal to hot fluid. That's why I'm considering MCCC TC naught minus TCA is equal to MHCH. TH minus TH naught. I am substituting all these values in this equation. So this is the TC naught equal to 43.01. So in this question only what is the value of TC naught value. That's why I am considering heat transfer rate. Cold fluid is equal to hot fluid. Coming to the second problem. So we already discussed in the previous classes what is overall heat transfer coefficient. In the data book page number, overall heat transfer coefficient. So here in this page number 156, this page number 156, the expression for overall heat transfer coefficient. So U naught is the outlet to overall heat transfer coefficient and UA is the inlet heat transfer coefficient. So here this is the formulas. This is the formulas for overall heat transfer coefficient inlet, and this is the formula for overall heat transfer coefficient at inlet temperature. So here now we can consider it as a the R naught. So here what is the R naught? R naught is equal to fouling factor resistance. So here this is the RF naught, fouling factor resistance, and this is also multiplied with fouling factor resistance. So we did not consider this fouling factor resistance. We can consider it as a overall heat transfer coefficient. Now we can observe overall heat transfer coefficient problems. In a double pipe heat exchanger, the hot fluid flowing through a pipe, inner diameter is 5 centimeters. So inner diameter, DA is equal to 5 centimeters and outer diameter is equal to 6 centimeters. That is D naught. With an inside heat transfer coefficient of 100. So inside heat transfer coefficient means THI. The pipe is made up of steel, is having some thermal conductivity 40 watt per meter Kelvin. So here the thermal conductivity is 40. In the annulus, that is outside of the pipe, the cold fluid is flowing with an outside heat transfer coefficient is. So here the outside heat transfer coefficient means H naught is 200 watt per meter Kelvin. Determine the overall heat transfer coefficient based on outer area per unit length of the tube. So here area is equal to per unit length, that means 1 meter square. Okay, so now we can observe, determine the overall heat transfer coefficient based on outer area. So now we can consider U naught value. So here L equal to, the area per unit length. So L equal to 1 meter. L equal to 1 meter. H naught value is given, K is given, and HA value is given. RA value and R naught value is given. So what is the formula in this general method? Without data book, we can consider it as a the total heat transfer thermal resistance is equal to inner thermal conductivity. So here this is the inner radius and this is the outer radius. So in the first unit we already calculated like this. So here this is the convection heat transfer coefficient, that means R value, Ri, R convection. So and this is the R conduction and this is again R convection. So this is inlet and this is conduction and this is convection outlet. So in the graphical in the thermal resistance representation, so we already calculated these problems in the first unit. So here convect 2, so here what is the convection? 1 by h into a, so this is the convection, and outlet is also 1 by h naught into a. So in the conduction process, ln of r naught minus r2 by 2 pi k ln, 2 pi k ln. So here this is also we are also calculating from data book page number. So now I am searching in the data book page numbers. Conduction. These are the properties values after completion of this conduction process. Next page. Here. This is the convective heat transfer formulas. So here R equal to 1 by 2 pi k ln into outer radius minus inner radius, like this. So we can calculate like this. So here H value is known term, Ri is known term, R naught is known term, all these values can substitute like this. So here the thermal resistance is equal to 0.095. So what is the overall heat transfer coefficient? U naught is equal to 1 by R thermal resistance into area. So here area equal to 2 pi L. So
2 pi
RL. So here 2 pi RL. So outer radius is 0.03 and length is equal to 1. So this is the generalized process. So now I can explain it as a heat exchanger problem. So here heat exchanger data book page number 156. Data book page number like this. So here overall heat transfer coefficient. Now I can consider as a data book page number 156 page number this formula. So here 1 by U naught is equal to 1 by H naught plus 1 by R of naught plus R naught by K, like this. So here this is the data book formula. So in this question, R of naught, resistance fouling factor is not given, that's why I am not considering like this. So we can consider it as a 0, value is not given. Take R of naught and R of a value is equal to 0. We can substitute all these values. So here U naught is equal to 58.36 watt per meter Kelvin. So in the generalized procedure and in this data book formula based answer is also same. This is the overall heat transfer coefficient problems. And now I can explain the now we can observe the fouling factor problems. So what is the difference between fouling factor and overall heat transfer coefficient? So in the previous classes we already discussed like this. So here the fouling factor is equal to the fouling factor is equal to 1 by U fouling plus RF plus 1 by U clean. So here this is the dirty layer that gradually build up of on heat transfer surface increases thermal resistance. This is according to the fouling factor resistant. According to the following factor resistance, according to the following factor resistance. So in a double pipe heat exchanger, oil flows through the annulus with the convective heat transfer coefficient. So here the double pipe oil flows, so that is hot oil, convective heat transfer coefficient H dot, which is heated by using hot water, flows through the Cu taken thermal conductivity value. Inside diameter 2 cm, that means Di, and outer diameter is 2.54 cm, outer diameter means D naught, having convective heat transfer coefficient, the Hi value, the fouling factor of water inside the fouling factor, the fouling factor means R value, fouling factor, fouling resistance value, Ri water. So Ri value and the fouling factor of oil Rf naught is 0.009. Determine the overall heat transfer coefficient based on outside area per meter length. So here a length is equal to 1 meter. So and we will also find the overall heat transfer coefficient neglecting fouling resistance on the both sides. So in the first case we can consider with fouling resistance, and second one neglect the fouling resistance value. So in this question we can the formula is taken from the data book page number 156. So here in this formulas, so first of all we need to consider Rf naught value and Rfa values like this. So here from data book page number 156 in the A bit, so all these values we can substitute, and 1 by U naught is equal to this value, U naught is equal to 385. This is the outer port. Determine the overall heat transfer coefficient based on outside area. That's why I'm considering U naught value. So we don't want to calculate UA value for this problem. So on coming to the B bit, neglect the fouling resistance value. So in the data book page number 156, we can neglect the fouling resistance values like this. So what is the formula? 1 by H naught and R naught by K, ln of R naught by R A, like this. So here we can neglect the fouling resistance formula for values. So this is the simplified equation. We can substitute all these values. U naught is equal to 844.04. The fouling factor reduced the overall heat transfer coefficient almost 54%. So here with fouling factor is 384 and without fouling factor 844. So this means more than, so here 385 and 844 is the almost 54% of the fouling factor reduced of the overall heat transfer coefficient. So now I am going to explain LMTD counterflow heat exchanger problems. So find the LMTD. So here LMTD means logarithmic mean temperature difference. Logarithmic mean temperature difference, the counterflow. So here in this problem, this is the LMTD counterflow arrangement. So which is the inlet and outlet temperature of the cold fluid. Inlet TCI and TC naught values is given, and that the hot fluid temperature is 130. So hot fluid inlet temperature is 130 and hot fluid outlet temperature is 50. So here the counterflow, we can draw it like this. So here hot fluid temperature and cold fluid temperature, hot fluid outlet and cold fluid inlet value like this. So in the simplified manner, delta TLM is equal to, from data book page number, data book page number 151. So in the counterflow heat exchanger, this is the formula, capital T1 minus T2 capital T1 minus T2 minus capital T2 minus small T1 by ln of T1 minus small T2 by T2 minus small T1. We can consider it from data book page number 151. We can substitute THA value, TC0 value, TCA and TH0 values like this. So here LMTD counter flow in the gate based manner like this, this diagram. So we already discussed in the previous derivation, LMTD of counter flow is equal to delta T1. What is delta T1? THA minus TC0. So 130 minus 100, and delta T is equal to 50 minus 40, like this. So this is the 18.20 simplified manner. Both answers are same. So from the LMTD parallel flow heat exchanger, so here LMTD, logarithmic mean temperature difference and parallel flow. Which cold fluid inlet? So which cold fluid inlet and outlet? Cold fluid inlet is TCA is 30 and TC0 is 60. And the hot fluid inlet and outlet temperatures are 140 and 90. So we can calculate LMTD of the parallel flow. So here this is the parallel flow heat exchanger diagram. TCA is given, TC0 is given, THA is given, TH0 is given. So from data book page number 151, this is the parallel flow heat exchanger formula. So we can consider from data book page number 151, we can substitute all four, that means inlet and outlet values in this equation. So delta TLM of the parallel flow is equal to 54.61. In the gate examinations and all other examinations, we can calculate in the simplified manner delta T1 and delta T2. So here this is the delta T1, and this is the delta T2. So we can consider it as here and substitute like this. So here 54.61, both answers are same. In this question, in a consider R12, condenser R12. So here refrigerating fluid 12. So here condenser problem. The condenses at 35 degrees, where the cooling fluid air in heat from 25 to 30 degrees centigrade. So here the cooling fluid. So here the TCI value is given and 25, and TC0 value is given. So we can observe like this. So here this is the condenser problem. The determine the LMTD of parallel flow and counter flow and class flow. So in the condenser, so we can observe like this. So here in the condensation problem, in the condenser problem, THI is equal to TH0. So this is the condenser problems. In the boiling problems, the cold fluid temperature is like this. So here TCI and TC0. So meek already previous class lo cheppanana. So ikkada endante condenser and represent chesinappudu condenser lo eppudu hot fluid temperature parallel to the x axis untundandi, parallel to the along the x axis. Ante ikkada manaku oka temperature ichchadu ante THI is equal to TH0 value ichinattu. కండెన్సర్ అయితే అదే ప్రాబ్లంలో బాయిలింగ్ అని రిప్రజెంట్ చేస్తే కోల్డ్ ఫ్లూయిడ్ టెంపరేచర్, అంటే హాట్ ఫ్లూయిడ్ టెంపరేచర్ గ్రాడ్యువల్గా డిక్రీజ్ అవుతుందండి, కోల్డ్ ఫ్లూయిడ్ బాయిలింగ్ దగ్గర ఎప్పుడు కూడా టీసీఐ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు టీసీ నాట్. సో ఇది గుర్తుపెట్టుకున్నాను. కండెన్సర్లు అయితే హాట్ ఫ్లూయిడ్ టెంపరేచర్ టీహెచ్ఏ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు టీహెచ్ నాట్, అదే బాయిలింగ్లో అయితే కోల్డ్ ఫ్లూయిడ్ టెంపరేచర్ సేమ్ ఉంటుందండి, అంటే ఈక్వల్ టు ఇన్లెట్ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు అవుట్లెట్ అవుతుంది అనమాట. ఓకే, సో ఇక్కడ మనకి ఏమి ఇచ్చారు చూడండి. సో హియర్ ద కండెన్సర్ ఆర్ ట్వెల్వ్. సో రెఫ్రిజరేటింగ్ ఫ్లూయిడ్ ఆర్ ట్వెల్వ్ ఫ్రమ్ డేటా బుక్ పేజ్ నెంబర్ 151. దిస్ ఈస్ ప్యారలల్ ఫ్లో, కౌంటర్ ఫ్లో అండ్ క్రాస్ ఫ్లో. వీ కెన్ కన్సిడర్ యాజ్ ఎ ప్యారలల్ ఫ్లో, వీ కెన్ సబ్స్టిట్యూట్ ఆల్ దీస్ వాల్యూస్. సో హియర్ టీ వన్ ఎంట్రీ టెంపరేచర్ అండ్ ఎగ్జిట్ టెంపరేచర్ ఈ 35, దట్స్ వై ఐమ్ కన్సిడరింగ్ టీ వన్ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు 35 అండ్ టీ టూ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు 35. So here this is the parallel flow heat exchanger formula. And coming to the counter flow, from data book page number 151, the counter flow formula we can consider it from like this. So here we can substitute this formula 7.21. In the condensation, in the condenser problem, parallel flow heat exchanger value 7.21 and the counter flow arrangement 7.21 are same values. Coming to the cross flow, what is the formula for cross flow? So here cross flow formula is Q equal to fouling factor U into delta T LM. So here cross flow is equal to fouling factor into delta T lm. So we already calculated lmt value. So in this question the following factor value is not given, that's why I'm considering f equal to 1. Why? Because of, so here f equal to 0, the counter flow is 0. In case of, we need to consider f equal to 0, 0 into lmtd of counter flow is equal to 0. So here there is no cross flow values, that's why I'm considering f equal to 1. So here lmtd of cross flow is equal to 1 into 7.21. So that equal to lmtd cross flow is equal to 7.21. So it is equal to counter flow value when any one fluid temperature remains constant throughout the length of the heat exchanger, that is during phase changes, the direction of flow is immaterial. Immaterial. So hence for condenser the evaporators, the LMTD is, hence the condensers and evaporators, the LMTD is same for parallel, counter and cross flow. So here this is the important point. So in the condensers and evaporators, the LMTD is same for parallel flow, counter flow and cross flow. So we already proved. So we already proved in the condenser. So parallel flow value is 7.21, counter flow value is 7.21 and cross flow value is 7.21. So in this condensers and evaporators, the same value is given for parallel and counter flow and cross flow equations. And coming to the next question. So here this is the evaporator. So here evaporator means the cold fluid temperature is parallel. So this is the hot fluid and this is the cold fluid. The THA value is given, TH0 value is given, and the evaporation, the TCI and TC0 is equal to 12 degrees. So we can substitute these equations. So here this is the parallel flow heat exchanger, that's why I'm considering these values. So here parallel flow heat exchanger 15.27. And coming to the next question, a double pipe heat exchanger is used to cool the lubricating oil like this. So lubricating oil means THA is equal to 90 degrees and TC0 is equal to 40 degrees using water available at 10 degrees. Using water available at 10 degrees. So here the water available at 10 degrees, the mass flow rate of oil. So here is the hot oil. Mass flow rate means MH is equal to specific heat, that means CPH, and that the water is 0.3 kg per second, that means MC, mass flow rate of the water is 0.3. Determine the heat transfer area U value for parallel flow arrangement and counter flow arrangement. The double pipe heat exchanger is used to cool the lubricating. So here in this equation, the inlet water temperature is 10 degrees. The outlet cold water temperature is not mentioned in this question. That's why I'm considering TC0 is equal to question mark. So here MH value, CPH and CC value and U value is given. So here U value is 50 watt per meter square Kelvin. So here what is the formula? The total heat transfer rate is equal to hot fluid temperature is equal to cold fluid temperature. That's why I'm considering MH, CH, THA minus TH0. So here TC0 value is unknown parameter. We can substitute all these values. The TC0 value is 22.68. So what is the heat exchanger formula? Heat exchanger Q equal to UA delta T LM. So here area is not given in the question. So Q value is Q equal to MH, CH into THA minus TC0. So after calculating Q value, we can substitute is equal to parallel flow and delta T LM. So here in this TC0 value is known, 22.68, we already calculated. We can substitute parallel flow like this and heat exchanger and counter flow arrangement like this. So here what is heat transfer rate? Q equal to UA delta T LM. So U equal to 50. So we can calculate area value. So in this question, the heat transfer area, determine the heat transfer area for parallel flow and counter flow. That's why I'm considering Q equal to UA delta T LM. In the parallel flow, the delta T LM value like this. We can substitute 40.96 value in this equation. So here area is unknown parameter, we need to calculate. So similarly, the counterflow formula, we can calculate to 46.17. We can substitute LMTD as a counterflow arrangement. A equal to 6.920. So here in this both cases, A equal to 7.8 and A equal to 6.920. For the same rating of heat exchangers, the area required for the counterflow heat exchanger is less than the of parallel flow. The counterflow arrangement is thermodynamically advantageous than the parallel flow. And the coming to the next problem, in a shell and tube condenser, steam condenses at 35 degrees. The water heated from, so TC, the water heated from, okay, TCI and TC naught. The rate of condenser of the steam, that means MH value. So here what is the MH value? 0.25. So this is the MH value, and latent heat of vaporization at 35 degrees may be taken as kilojoule per kg, and the water flowing through the pipe is 2.54 outer diameter. Determine the number of tubes required. We can calculate, determine the number of tubes required. Each tube is 2 meters length. Assume U0 is equal to 1500. So in this condensation, so inlet water temperature is equal to outlet water temperature of the hot fluid. So here TC and TCH0 value is given. So MH value is given. The HFC value, the latent heat of vaporization, the kilojoule per kg. So we can convert it into joules. The pipe diameter is 2.54 centimeters. It can be converted for meters. L equal to 2 meters of length. Overall heat transfer coefficient at outside is equal to 1500 watt per meter Kelvin. So now I can consider like this. Both are parallel flow conditions. We can substitute all these values. The delta TLM for parallel flow equal to 5.4. The rate of heat transfer, Q equal to UA delta TLM. We can substitute these parallel flow delta TLM value like this. So here area is unknown parameter. So here area is unknown parameter, we need to calculate. So here Q is also unknown parameter. So what is Q? M into HFC. So HFC value, the latent heat of vaporization HFC value is given in the problem. So that's why I am considering Q is equal to MH into HFC. So MH equal to 0.25 and HFC value like this. So Q, we can what is the Q value? 600 kilowatts and UA. So this is the area value. So in this area, how many number of tubes we are used in this double pipe heat exchangers? A0 is equal to, what is A0? Pi D0 L into number of tubes. Pi D0 L into number of tubes. Diameter is given, L equal to 2 meters into number of tubes. So here what is A0 is equal to 73.26 pi DL into number of tubes. That's why number of tubes is equal to 459. A shell and tube heat exchanger is to heat 1000 kg per hour the water from 16 degrees to 84. So here TCI and TC naught. So here heat MH, mass flow rate. The hot engine oil flows through the shell. The oil makes a single shell pass. So we can underline this, single shell pass entering at 160 degrees. Entering at 160 degrees, that means THI, and leaving at 94, that means TH0. With the average heat transfer coefficient, average heat transfer coefficient means H value. The water flow through the 11 brass tubes. So here how many number of tubes? 11 brass tubes and 29 mm inner diameter and 25.4 mm outer diameter. DA is equal to 22.9 and D0 is equal to 25.4 mm. With each tube makes 4 passes. So underline like this. So here one shell pass and four passes like this. So through the shell, assuming fully developed flow for the water, find the required tube length for pass. Find the required tube length for pass. So here in this question, the MC, MH value. So here the shell and tube heat exchanger is to heat 1000 of water. So here this is the cold water, MC value is given. MC is equal to in terms of. So here CC value is not mentioned. The water inlet temperature is mentioned. The hot oil inlet temperature and outlet temperature is mentioned. The average heat transfer coefficient value. That means overall heat transfer coefficient U value is given. So TI value, T naught value is given. Use data book for correction factor. So correction factor. So here in this question, the single shell pass and the four passes is given. The single shell pass and four passes is given. That's why I am considering data book page number 1. Single shell pass. Single shell pass and four passes. So here correction factor. Now I can read like this. So here the hot oil makes a single shell pass, enters at 160 degrees and leave at 94. So here determine with each tube makes four passes. From data book page number 159, we can observe like this. The correction factor plot from exchanger. Two shall pass. So here one shall pass and 2, 4, 6 multi-tube passes. So in this question, single pass and four passes like this. So here in this, the correction fraction plot from the heat exchanger, one pass shall. That's why I'm considering data book page number 158 and four passes like this. So here this is the four passes. So in this graphical representation, we need to calculate R value and P value in the given values. So here the capacity ratio R value T1 minus capital T2 by T2 minus T1. That means THA minus TH0 by TC0 minus TCA. So R value is 0.97. In this graphical representation, R value is 0.97. What is the 0 point? Where is the 0.97? This is the R value is 0.4.0, 3.0, 2.0, 1.5 and 1. So here this is the 0.97 graphical representation. And now we can calculate P value. What is P value? So P value is 0.47. From graphical representation, 0.47 means like this. So we can draw a vertical line. So this is the 0.9 something value. So here in this graphical representation, the value is 0.9 something. So in our in the graphical representation, we can observe like this. So here 0.47 value and R value is 0.97 like this. So here 0.97 like this. So here this is the 0.86 value from graph. We can substitute following for correction factor. So here this is the correction factor. So F value is Q equal to F UA delta T LM. So here counter flow. So delta T LM is equal to counter flow. So we can substitute counter flow values like this. So delta T LM. After that we can calculate rate of heat transfer F U. So here F equal to what is the how much value? 0.86. We can substitute F value like this. So we don't know the Q value. So we know the Q formula. So in this cold fluid, MCCC is equal to TC0 minus TCA. So here CC value taken from data book page number 21. So here in this question, the water is cold fluid. So the cold fluid temperature at inlet temperature is cold fluid inlet temperature. That means water properties. That means data book page number 21. Data book page number 21. Water. Data book page number 21. The CC value, specific heat at or data book page number 21 is specific heat like this 4216 at 100 degrees. So in this question, the heat exchange is 1000 degrees. We can consider it as a single pass and four passes. That's why I'm considering CP value, specific heat value 4216. Or otherwise, we can take inlet temperature value is also inlet temperature. So here CP is equal to 4185. That's why I'm substituting all these values. So area is equal to, so we can calculate number of tubes. Area equal to pi dl, diameter is equal to this one, l equal to unknown parameter, number of tubes is already given 11. So what is the length of the tube is equal to 34.02. The tube length is 34.02. The shell length is equal to l by number of passes. So how many number of passes? 4 number of passes is given. That's why L by 4 equal to, the shell length is 8.5 meters. The shell is 8.5 meters. So these are the overall heat transfer coefficient problems and the fouling factor problems and LMTD, parallel flow heat exchanger and counter flow heat exchangers problem. And how can you calculate the capacity ratio and temperature difference problems from the graphical representations like this from data book page number 158. These are the problems.